Welcome back. The demolition of the Champlain Bridge brought down a piece of history, but it also helped uncover some.
Yeah, here's what happened. When scientists found out just how many artifacts were on the grounds around that demolition site, well, the builders, they worked around the site, and the archaeologists, they kept doing their job. They kept digging, finding items from as far back as 9,000 years ago. News Channel 5's David Schneider gives us a sneak peek at tonight's Champlain Connection.
Archaeologists from the University of Vermont dug up evidence of a French fort that once stood at Chimney Point, also artifacts from one of Vermont's first pottery makers. But that's not all.
We've also found evidence of Native American occupation dating back as early as 9,000 years ago.
9,000 years ago. Crock says the map would have been drawn a lot differently, with a lot more water.
In Vermont, the point was actually underwater when Lake Champlain was an ocean. But as soon as that Champlain Sea receded, people began to occupy this area, and we have stone tool evidence of that.
But Dr. Crock says some of the most interesting findings come from fire pits and hearths, which, along with the area's acidic soil, preserve artifacts very well.
Probably some sort of rodent tooth. I imagine there's fish bone in here. Some of it's burned, some of it's unburned.
The researchers say archaeology is most exciting at two points: when they find a site in the field, and when they sort through the soil back in the lab.
You know, I just finished washing the raw dirt out, which goes into this float tank below me, where it'll be filtered out. And then from that, we get artifacts like, this looks to be a tooth, a stone tool, Native American stone tool.
The crew also found artifacts left over from one of the very first potters in the state, Moses Bradley.
Even manufacturing scraps of clay that actually have his fingerprints on them. So very exciting kind of look into the early industry of colonial Vermont. We have almost every period of Vermont history, human history, represented right in this small area. So it's been really exciting and a wonderful opportunity for us.
And one that will help paint a more complete picture of the past.
We'll learn a lot from the work that we've done there that will fill in gaps in periods of history in Vermont that we didn't have any information for before.
The Champlain Connection, David Schneider, News Channel 5.
Well, Dr. Crock will be speaking about the findings on campus tomorrow night. That's at the Waterman Building in Memorial Lounge, starting at 7:30 p.m.